हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन वेलकम इन द लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ ए चैप्टर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर, दैट इज थर्ड वन, वी हैव सीन वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ लिक्विड्स इन लिक्विड्स, फॉलोड बाय रॉल्ट लॉ. रॉल्ट लॉ इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एवरीवेयर. देन आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस वेयर देर इज no change in heat, no change in volume taking place. Non-ideal solutions which will not obey the conditions of ideal solutions. Positive deviation from Rolle law and negative deviation from Rolle law. And in this lecture, we are supposed to start with the colligative properties of solutions. This is the important part from our chapter. See, what are colligative properties and how they are utilized? What is the use of colligative properties? That is important part. So attend over here. Colligative properties are the properties which are depending on number of solute particle, but not depending on the nature of a solute particle or size of a solute particle. Colligative properties are the properties which are depending on number of solute particles but not depending on the nature of solute particle or size of solute particle. These are depending only on the number of solute particle. Further, these are the properties of non-electrolytes. These are properties of non-electrolyte solute. Further, these are the properties of dilute solutions. Dilute solutions will show colligative properties. Dilute solutions means concentration of solution is very less. Very less proportion of solute is used. These colligative properties are the properties of dilute solutions. And these are properties of aqueous solutions. We have studied what is meant by aqueous solution and what is meant by non-aqueous solution. What are aqueous solutions? Aqueous solutions are the solutions in which solvent used is water. So colligative properties are the properties of aqueous solutions. And these properties are used for non-volatile solute. Solute must be non-volatile and non-electrolyte. Non-electrolyte, here I have told. The solute should be non-volatile, must not be evaporated. It should not exert a vapor pressure. It should be non-volatile. And these properties are used to calculate molar mass, means molecular weight of solute, that is non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. Molar mass of solute, M2, can be calculated using colligative properties. These are the important points in relation to colligative properties. Colligative properties are the properties which are depending on number of solute particles but not depending on size or nature of solute particle. These are the properties of non-electrolyte solute. These are the properties of very dilute solutions where proportion of solute is very less. These are the properties of aqueous solutions in which solvent used is water. These are the properties of non-volatile solute which is not undergoing evaporation. And these are the properties used for calculation of molar mass of solute. These are important points. And there are four colligative properties which are used for calculation of molar mass of solute. They are vapor pressure lowering of vapor pressure lowering, then boiling point elevation, increase in boiling point. Third, depression in freezing point or freezing point depression, decrease in freezing point. And fourth is osmotic pressure. Four colligative properties are there: vapor pressure lowering, then boiling point elevation, freezing point depression, and osmotic pressure. Those are the four colligative properties. Let us start with one by one. First colligative property is vapor pressure lowering. Lowering of vapor pressure. First of all, see what is meant by vapor pressure, and then what is the lowering of vapor pressure. In the last lecture, I have told you that vapor pressure we are studying in the next one. So what is vapor pressure? See over here. And then I will tell you what is the lowering of vapor pressure and how that is used to calculate the molar mass of non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. What is vapor pressure? See here. Suppose we have one beaker, and in that beaker we have taken a solvent, pure solvent. Four molecules. Second layer, four molecules. Third layer, four molecules. One more, four molecules. In all, I have taken 16 molecules of solvent. Here is a pure solvent I have taken. Whenever this is heated, how does the heating take place? We know. First of all, molecules present at the bottom layer absorb heat, goes at the top. Molecules at the top which are in cold condition comes at the bottom. Again they will absorb heat, they will go at the top, and the cycle take place. During that heating, what will happen? Since we are heating, molecules from bottom layer enters to the top layer, molecules at the top layer comes at the bottom. So what is generated? Kinetic energy is generated. Here kinetic energy is generated. There kinetic energy goes on increasing. If we close this at the top, so what will happen is that in between top layer and its bottom layer, top layer molecule and the second one, in between them there is a force of attraction. There is a force of attraction, first and second layer, or second and third, third and fourth. There is a force of attraction. This force of attraction is known as internal energy, or that is the intermolecular energy. Due to that intermolecular energy, the molecules are bonded with each other. But due to heating, what happens? Kinetic energy increases. And whenever kinetic energy becomes greater than intermolecular energy, at that time this bond is broken. And what happens? Molecule at the top get converted into gaseous state. So all these four molecules converted into gaseous phase, and they exert a pressure on this lid, and that pressure is known as vapor pressure. And at equilibrium, rate of condensation of gas to liquid is same as that of the rate of conversion of liquid to gas. At that time, these molecules exert pressure on the liquid state. There is equilibrium between liquid and gas. So this gas molecule exert certain pressure on the liquid, and that pressure is known as vapor pressure. You got it? What is meant by vapor pressure? Now, vapor pressure lowering, I am telling you. What is vapor pressure lowering? Let us consider the another beaker. In another beaker, we have a solution. Here we have taken pure solvent. Suppose this pure solvent has vapor pressure P10. Now vapor pressure of solution we have to calculate. Here vapor pressure is P10. Now solution. Again 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is a solution. Solution means what? It is a mixture of solute plus solvent. Solute and solvent. Here mixture we have taken. This is pure solvent containing how many molecules we have considered? 16 molecules. 4 layers. Here also 4 layers. But they are layers of solute and solvent. Means some of the solvent molecules are replaced by solute molecules. This is solute, this is solute, this is solute, this is solute. Because some of the solvent molecules are replaced by solute, forming a solution. In this case, all the molecules are solvent. Here, some of the molecules are solute. Is that solute volatile or non-volatile? Non-volatile. So, can it be converted into gaseous state? No. Since that is non-volatile, that is not converted into gaseous state. If this is heated, heating takes place by the same manner. Molecules at the bottom goes at the top. Molecules at the top comes at the bottom. Cyclic heating takes place. Kinetic energy here also may become greater than the intermolecular energy. At that time, these layers get separated from each other. Surface layer is separated from the second layer. And how many molecules are converted into gaseous state? Is it 4 or is it 3? 3 only. Because this is non-volatile. Solute molecule is non-volatile. It is not converted into gaseous phase. So how many molecules are converted into gaseous phase? Is it 3 or 4? Only 3. And these 3 molecules exert a pressure. Here how many molecules are exerting pressure? 4 molecules. So if we take pure solvent, vapor pressure is P10. If we take a solution, let its vapor pressure is P1. Can you tell me which one is greater? Whether vapor pressure of solution is greater than solvent or solvent is greater than solution on the lead? Which will exert more pressure? 4 molecules or 3 molecules? It is the 4 molecules which will exert more pressure than the 3 molecules. Therefore, P10 is greater than P1. P10 is greater than P1 because P10 is vapor pressure of pure solvent and P1 is the vapor pressure of solution. And that difference, delta P, change in pressure is P10 minus P1. This difference is known as vapor pressure lowering. You got it? The difference between vapor pressure of pure solvent and vapor pressure of solution is known as vapor pressure lowering. And that lowering of vapor pressure is used to calculate the molar mass of non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. See it, how that is applicable. Vapor pressure lowering. We know vapor pressure lowering is delta P equal to P10 minus P1. Now, how P10 is calculated? We have seen in the last lecture, according to Raoult law, that P10 is vapor pressure in the pure state. P1 is vapor pressure in the mixture. Just now we have studied it. P1 is vapor pressure of solvent, but in the solution. So this is known as a partial, because in solution there are two components, solute and solvent. So P1 is known as a partial vapor pressure, and that partial vapor pressure P1 is calculated according to Raoult's law, or even we can write one more step. P1, according to Raoult's law, partial vapor pressure of solvent in a solution is equal to the its vapor pressure in pure state multiplied by mole fraction x1. Mole fraction of solvent, vapor pressure of solvent in pure state, and vapor pressure of solvent in the solution. This is Raoult's law. We are studying the binary systems. From this one, what will happen? If we plot P1 as a function of X1, we will get the straight line passing through origin having P1 0 as a slope. Y is equal to mx plus 0. So y plotted as a function of x, slope is m, intersect is 0, that is the line passing through origin. In the similar manner, if partial vapor pressure in solution is plotted as a function of x1, its mole fraction in the solution, we will get the straight line passing through origin with slope is equal to its vapor pressure in pure state. For binary solutions, we know it is a two component system, and summation of x1 plus x2 will be equal to 1. Mole fraction of first component, solvent. Mole fraction of second component, solute. That is equal to 1. x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. Therefore, from this equation, what is x1? It is 1 minus x2. Substituting over here also, we can write P1 will be equal to P1 0 1 minus x2, or P1 will be equal to P1 0 minus P1 0 x2. This bracket I have solved, nothing is there. If I take P1 on right side and this part on left side, what we will get? We will get P1 0 is equal to, sorry, this I have taken on right side, means P1 0 minus P1 will be equal to, this taken on left side become plus P1 0 x2. Are you getting it? How I have done this? This taken on right side, so P1 0 minus P1, and this taken on left side, minus become plus, so P1 0 x2. What is this P1 0 minus P1? It is vapor pressure lowering. This is known as a vapor pressure lowering. Therefore, delta P will be equal to P1 0 minus P1. That is nothing but equal to P1 0 x2. This is a lowering of vapor pressure. And from this equation, or from this equation also, we can write one more step. Delta P means P1 0 minus P1. P1 0 minus P1 divided by P1 0 taken on left side. P1 0 will be equal to x2. And this is known as relative lowering of vapor pressure. What is this difference? This difference is known as lowering of vapor pressure. And the ratio of lowering of vapor pressure to the vapor pressure of solvent in pure state is known as relative lowering of vapor pressure. This is relative lowering of vapor pressure, and that relative lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. And you know how to calculate the mole fraction of solute? Mole fraction of solute or any component is nothing but the moles of that component in the solution divided by total moles. So moles of solute N2 divided by total moles is N2 plus N1, means moles of solute plus moles of solvent. This part, moles, how to calculate mole fraction, you have studied in the last year. It is a ratio of number of moles of one component to the total number of moles of all component in the solution. So what is N2? It is number of moles of solute. N2 is number of moles of solute. N1 is number of moles of solvent. So mole fraction of solute is the total moles of solute divided by total moles of solute plus solvent. And we are studying dilute solutions. Dilute solutions. For dilute solution, solvent is very much greater as compared with the solute. Therefore, N1 is very much greater than N2. Therefore, N2 plus N1 will be equal to only N1. N1. Because solvent is used in large excess proportion. So, X2 will become N2 upon N1. And further, we know what is N2 and what is N1. N2 is nothing but number of moles of solute. Is the mass of solute divided by molar mass of solute, W2 upon M2. Similarly, N1 is nothing but W1 divided by M1. N2 and N1 is known. So what is X2? X2 will be equal to N2 upon N1, means W2 divided by M2 multiplied by opposite way. Is it W1 upon M1 or M1 upon W1? This will be M1 upon W1. And now replacing this X2 by that factor, we can write this equation as P10 minus P1 divided by P10 will be equal to W2 M1 divided by M2 W1. From this equation, how M2 is calculated? Take M2 on left side, this part on right side, this part on right side. So P10 W2 M1 divided by, this is P10 minus P1 into W1, or this we can write as delta P. Therefore, finally we can write M2 will be equal to P10 W2 M1 divided by delta P W1. This is the molar mass of solute. Molar mass of non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. And this is the aim. This is the main aim of colligative property, to determine, to calculate the molar mass of non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. See this expression again and again. So that this expression to calculate the molar mass of solute M2 is important. You must know how to derive this equation. That is the important part. And in the next lecture, we will start with the next colligative property, second colligative property.